respect to conflicts of interest. We've got the zoning procedures law contains specific safeguards with respect to a conflicted vote. Typically, with respect to things, if you or a family member have any sort of a financial or personal interest in the matter that is coming up before you for zoning action, you're supposed to announce, you're supposed to provide a written document evidencing that you have a conflict, and you're supposed to recuse. We also have in Forsyth County, we have an ethics code, which is actually more broad than just the zoning procedures ethics rules. And it basically says, I can't summarize all of it in one little sound bite, but it basically says that if you are considering taking action on a matter where you cannot make an objective, neutral, and unbiased decision based upon either a personal affiliation or a financial affiliation, then you should not take that action. And you should again announce, and you should recuse. And you know where I stand on that. I hope all of you do. And I think that you need to give those considerations full play in every zoning that comes up in front of you. I think most of you try to do that. The ones that I've had encounters with and experience with, I know that you're trying to do that. And I know that the Board of Commissioners attempts to do it as well. But they're serious, and a conflicted vote in a zoning matter can actually render the entire zoning void, invalid. Just something to keep in mind. There's plenty of case law on that, and I think I've used this analogy before, but typically ethics is sort of a bright line, and no one ever fell off a cliff 30 feet away from the edge, right? So you try to keep back a little bit.
Can you have one? Conflict of interest, if you don't know that you got a conflict of interest, can you have a conflict of interest without knowing that it's actually a conflict?
Well, I'm going to answer the question, but let me get out my explanation. The whole point of a conflict of interest is that because of the relationship or the financial interest or what have you, your ability to make an impartial, neutral, and objective vote fulfilling your civic obligation cannot be taken, because you are making your decision based upon what? Something other than your civic duty. So if you don't know you have a conflict, you don't know, wait for it. If you don't know, can you be guilty of an unethical act if you didn't even know enough to be able to take that sort of a conflicted decision? You would think the answer would be no. But I think at the end of the day, the better approach is that if you have a conflict, and even if you weren't aware of it at the time, I think the end result will be the law won't care.
So ignorance of a conflict of interest is not an excuse for...
Yes, that's what I believe. True, not a conflict that's sort of one of those, we've talked about them in here before, sort of an appearance of impropriety. I'm talking about if you have a disqualifying event based upon a spousal or some sort of a familial relationship, and you may not have been aware of it. I don't think the law, if there was a challenge to a zoning by a neighbor who says you had a conflict, and the answer from you is I didn't know I had it, I don't think the court will care whether you knew it or not. If there is truly a disqualifying conflict, I don't think the court would.
But probably the best way, to discover if you have a conflict of interest is to identify all the parties affiliated with an application.
That would seem reasonable.
Would that be proper?
That would seem reasonable.
So you should, because I've thought a lot about that, and I've kind of brought that up a few times. And somewhere along the line, maybe some point in time, we can, when somebody's presenting an application to the Planning Commission, I think it should be accompanied by a rezoning affidavit package explaining who the parties are, so that we don't run the risk of having a conflict of interest.
And this is where you get into that balancing issue, because on the one hand, we have ethical duties, and then we have duties under the UDC. And on the one hand, we're supposed to make land use decisions and recommendations based upon the public policy of land use. On the other hand, to the extent we have ethical obligations, we're supposed to make those based upon who is in fact impacted by those land use decisions. And so we have to keep those allegiances clear, but yeah, your point's well taken.
Well, we have the county attorney here. I would like to hear his take on something like this.
We discussed this, I think, at the last training session we did, and I think we talked about the notion of a conflict of interest and what that would mean, and I think that the conclusion we reached is that a conflicted vote in the zoning action can void the actual action taken, and in the case that you didn't know it, I mean, you know, you go down those hypotheticals, but if you didn't know you had a conflict, could you have been influenced by the unknowable, you know? But I think the way I concluded in my presentation was, I'm not sure a reviewing court would care. I think that practically speaking, you still wouldn't have had the culpability, but to the extent your brother was on the LLC that was the applicant, you know, if you didn't know that, candidly, first of all, shame on you if you didn't know that. And secondly, I think a reviewing court would say, well, you know, you should have known it. So this wouldn't trouble me at all. I've never seen one quite this exacting before, but I just had a chance to look through it. But, you know, what this reminded me of when I first looked at it, it reminded me of a certificate of interested persons in federal court. Is what it reminded me of. Whenever you've got federal court litigation, the first thing you have to identify is basically everyone who has any potential interest in litigation. And it's for, so the district judges will know if they need to recuse or not. So that's the first
thing. There's nothing wrong with, well, I appreciate your comments.
No, there's nothing wrong at all with it.